Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I'm here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and informing you about all the latest treatments in cardiology. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any videos that I post. Ultrasound scan of the heart, also known as echocardiography, is a very common and routine cardiac test that is performed regularly on patients with heart disease. It evaluates the heart anatomy and heart function. There are two types of echocardiography. The first is done by putting a transducer on the chest wall over the heart. This is known as transthoracic echocardiography. The second type is done by sedating the patient and passing an ultrasound transducer down the esophagus to the back of the heart for clear evaluation of the cardiac structures and function. This is known as transesophageal echocardiography. Today, I'll be talking to you about the transthoracic echocardiography, the modality that we perform by putting the ultrasound transducer probe on the chest wall over the heart, and it is often used as the first-line cardiac imaging modality owing to its wide availability and non-invasiveness and lack of radiation exposure. Using this technique, we obtain two-dimensional echo information, generally known as 2D echo, in addition to Doppler blood flow information, generally known as Doppler echo. I will concentrate on the two-dimensional echo in this video. In performing the procedure, the patient is brought to the echo laboratory and placed on an examination table in the supine position. The echo transducer is then applied to the chest wall over the heart, and the transducer is moved to different positions on the chest to acquire different pictures of the heart from different locations. Most labs follow the recommendations of the American Society of Echocardiography with respect to image display, with the transducer position depicted at the top of the screen, with the heart anatomy more distant from the transducer and shown at the lower region of the display, with the lateral or the left structures to the right of the screen, and the medial or the right structures to the right of the screen. I will now talk about the different ultrasound transducer positions that we routinely use during echocardiography. The first position is what we label as parasternal long axis view. The ultrasound transducer is placed in the third or fourth left intercostal space. This is the image that we first get. As seen in this video, and as I point with the arrow, the aortic valve is in the center of the screen with the right and posterior cusps shown. Then you can see immediately to the right of the valve a slight dilatation known as the sinuses of Valsalva. And more to the right of it is the aorta, which is displayed as a tubular structure. I then zoom out and you can still see the aortic valve and the aorta. And in addition, you see the left atrium, the mitral valve with the anterior mitral valve leaflet and the posterior mitral valve leaflet. On the top of the screen, you see the right ventricle. And you can see the septal wall of the left ventricle and the inferolateral wall of the left ventricle. Then I rotate my transducer 90 degrees, and I get what we call as a parasternal short axis view. This is how it looks like. In the center of the screen, you see the aortic valve. The normal aortic valve has three leaflets. You can see the right cusp here, the posterior cusp here, and the left cusp here. Just above that, you see the pulmonary valve, and on the left of the screen, you see the right ventricle, and the tricuspid valve, and the right atrium, and above and to the right, the pulmonary artery. Then I tilt my probe to concentrate on the mitral valve. In this view, I see the right ventricle, the left ventricle, which looks like a circle in this short axis view, and the mitral leaflets with the anterior leaflet, the posterior leaflet displayed in the middle of the circle. Then I angle my transducer slightly to the left ventricle at the level of the papillary muscles, with the left ventricle still looking circular in this view. At this time, I need to focus on getting a good assessment of the right side of the heart, and I tilt my echo transducer to the right side. And here, I can see the posterior leaflet of the tricuspid valve, the anterior leaflet, the anterior wall of the right ventricle, and the inferior wall of the right ventricle, and here is the right atrium. Then I move my transducer to the apex of the heart to get what we call the apical four-chamber views. This is how it looks like with the left side of the heart displayed on the right side of the screen and the right side of the heart displayed on the left side of the screen. You can see here the left atrium, the mitral valve, the left ventricle, the right ventricle, and the right atrium. In this view, I then zoom into individual chambers to assess them and perform measurements. Here, I concentrate on the left ventricle and assess its walls, and you can also see clearly the anterior leaflet of the mitral valve and the posterior leaflet of the mitral valve. I then tilt my probe slightly to change the angle and be able to assess the aortic valve. I then tilt my transducer to get the apical two-chamber views, in which only the left ventricle and the left atrium are displayed. Then I tilt my probe to see the apical three-chamber view, as can be seen here, with the left atrium, the anterior mitral valve leaflet, the posterior mitral valve leaflet, the aortic valve, and the left ventricle with its different walls. From here, I move my probe to the lower part of the chest and perform the subcostal views. I first get a view of the inferior vena cava to assess whether it is dilated or not, as can be seen here. I then tilt my probe to view the heart from this subcostal position. You can see here the interatrial septum, the tricuspid valve, the right atrium, the right ventricle, the left ventricle, and the left atrium. During my echo examination, I get information about the size of the heart chambers, about the regional abnormalities of the heart chambers, and information about the heart valves. In addition, I use Doppler ultrasound imaging to evaluate the flow of blood through the heart valves. I also perform tissue Doppler imaging, especially to evaluate excursion of the tissue at the tricuspid valve and the mitral valve levels. I will talk about the echo Doppler evaluations and the tissue Doppler imaging in another video. If you have any question about what I presented to you today, or any cardiology question in general, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comments section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad, helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.